What's going on, guys? Welcome back to UFC 3. We are currently 4-0 with Ray Taylor. This is the lightweight division career. I only say that, I'm going to try and keep saying at the start of every video, because we could have multiple careers going. We just never shut up, Munozo. We've already beat your ass. What are you talking shit for? Shut the fuck up, bro. I'll slap you. Let's see who we can fight today. Noah Sexton. He's another dude we could have fought before. Let's run it with Noah Sexton. This should be good. We're going to try and squeeze two fights in today. I think the first episode was really long in comparison to what I want for the rest, but if we have like a full three-round fight, then that'll probably be the only fight for the video. But let's be honest, at this level, that's probably not going to happen. Even when I played on Legendary, I went to decision maybe twice, if that. Like, it doesn't really happen. You even on Legendary, even on Hard, even on Pro, even on Regular, even on Amateur, even on the easiest difficulty, you could, no matter how bad you are, you cannot go to decision. You almost have to try to go to decision to a certain point, because as long as you work the body, work the legs, work the head, and keep doing it, eventually your opponent will crack, or you'll crack. It just depends. I don't really want to stay at the jiu-jitsu gym anymore, so we're going to change gym and go to Carissi's boxing gym. Alright guys, we just unlocked some stuff here. We unlocked jab level 3, so that'll be a bit of snappy now. Should be a little bit boom. Like that. And then what else did we unlock? I forgot. Lead body hook. Nice. We've actually been trying to use the lead body hooks as well, so that's quite handy really. And we unlocked a final perk that we can now make 5 in total, which is when suffering a health event, your strikes do more damage. I doubt we'll be suffering a health event anytime soon, but you never know. Alright guys, it's time for fight night. Oh. Thought it was going to get up to medium then. We still trained hard, don't worry. And we finally get that. That's the reason I mainly selected this fighter, is because I realised we're on the left side, which means we finally get to be in the home shorts, which we never get to do for some reason. It's very annoying. But thank you, Brandon Moreno. Still getting a little bit of hate, but it's cool.
Well, what a pop from the crowd as this guy makes the walk. Such a well-rounded fighter. And you got to think, when the opponent breaks him down on film, not a lot of weaknesses jump out of the video. This is a true mixed martial artist. May not stand out in any one area, but plus skills across the board. Probably comfortable just about anywhere this fight goes tonight.
This guy is extremely well-rounded. His submissions are world-class. His striking is excellent. And he is extremely unpredictable in what attack he chooses to go with.
You know, we trot out the term well-rounded in modern-day mixed martial arts maybe more than we should, but this guy fits the bill. Maybe doesn't stand out in any one area on film, but plus skills everywhere. And you gotta think tonight, Joe, with his skill set, he's more than comfortable really anywhere this fight goes. If he needs to stand and strike, he can do it. If the fight hits the canvas, he can submit you. A lot of different skills brought to the table by this young man.
This guy is very well-rounded. He literally has no weaknesses in his game. He is technical in all areas of mixed martial arts.
Kill the tape for this lightweight scrap.
Alright.
So these fighters relatively close in age.
I'm going to skip Bruce Buffer's intro and jump right into it. Touch gloves.
Well, it's a building that has hosted so many classic fights. We are underway at Madison Square Garden, right here in the heart of New York City. So he won his UFC debut by knockout. So you got to think the confidence is sky high as he tries to move to 2-0 in the big show here tonight. No nerves whatsoever when he made the UFC debut, and the results really spoke to that. So now a little bit more pressure on him, added audience, more eyeballs. We'll see if he can respond to that pressure and deliver another knockout performance here tonight. Oh, he found the target there. That'll work.
Nice combos, and he's down.
Fuck?
Orthodox for much of the fight. He's going southpaw here, Joe. Well, he walked into his opponent's range there and ate that hook. He was unprotected, unguarded, and he's been susceptible to that hook in previous UFC fights. Gotta figure out a way to move those feet and ultimately
show. Now he goes for the single leg.
That was terrible. I didn't mean to do that. He meant to do that, though. Fair play to him. I need a guillotine.
He switched stances back to southpaw here. Oh. Nice.
I need a guillotine, I feel like.
Oh, and he connects there. Nice inside leg kick.
Okay. Get the fuck out of there.
Fighter facing the orthodox fighter always has the advantage of the back leg kick to the body. It opens up that liver kick because the left kick lands on the right side of the opponent's body, which is a very vulnerable area. High kick! He heard him! This could be it! Excellent movement on the ground. Boom. He's always trying to better his position.
I'll just wait. I'll just wait for you to do your thing, bro. I'll just yeet you up like this. Bang!
And he landed the right hand there.
What's up with it? What's up with it, huh?
He's going after that rear naked choke here.
What's up with it, huh? I got this. This is easy money. Fuck.
Looks like he's got it.
Oh,
now
I don't know actually
on.
Now.
He's
going
to
fuck that.
Now. He's trying to go palm to palm. He goes with the body triangle to lock
fuck
him into place.
My thumb slipped.
Now he puts his hand on his bicep.
Oh, I fucked it. I fucked it. I've absolutely fucked it. Fuck. That was so easy as well.
Nice hammer fist. He lands a big shot from the bottom.
Just gonna fucking hammer him with these.
Nice combination of strikes.
Boom, get off. Oh, I fucked that so hard. I haven't done submission in ages. Great work on the ground. Yeah, I fucked that submission though, bro. I could have got that. This could be over. It's alright. It's no big deal. No big deal. I don't think he's gonna make it. My leg's a little bit red, but you fucking bitch! I went to touch gloves with you as well. Bang! The fake, fake. Fuck. Trick him again with that. Bang, bang. Let's go, baby. Fuck you. Let's go.
Roundhouse kick for the knockout. Indeed, Joe, that was a tremendous kick to end the fight tonight. Caught the opponent flush with full force and extension.
I mean, that was like the first time I don't know if I'd say struggled. I don't know if I'd say I struggled, but just one that I...
Let's take a look at that
first
again.
Time I'd faced issues, I suppose, when I got rocked. But, you know, that was just me. I could have done better. But we learned. Bang.
And he's out.
Joosh. And the ref comes, shoves me off.
So a seminal moment for
Let's
him
go.
Here tonight as he gets the huge knockout
victory. Let's go, baby.
Here's Bruce Buffer now with the official decision.
Good stuff. Who won the first round? Of course, me. We dominated the first round pretty hard. It felt like he went for a lot of takedowns, but it didn't ever count them. I don't know why it didn't count them. He went for a lot of takedowns. A little bit annoying that we didn't get that submission. No one really sticks out here. I might go with this guy. Yeah, I'm gonna fight this guy. Andrew Perez. Finally, guys, we unlocked something I really wanted to unlock, and that is the overhand. That's a beastie shot, and we're definitely going to land a knockout at some point with that shot. Oh, let me land. There we go. Finally, we unlocked the overhand. We've got heavy hands here as well, which increases damage of hooks. I don't really like to throw when I'm in a stunned state, so I'm going to get rid of that one. I don't feel like I need that stunned state one, because like when I'm stunned, I tend to just maybe throw one jab and back all the way up. So that seems unnecessary. Alright, guys, I didn't do much boosting. I only had 3 weeks to train. I want to make sure I was going in with full health and peak fitness. During my sparring, I learned this guy is apparently a dynamic wrestler. So we're going to have to watch out for the takedowns. And if he does get, we're going to have to not go over takedowns, because I tried to do one in the sparring and he got stuffed. And this guy seems to have good wrestling transitions, so I don't really want to risk it too much. But we should be okay.
Well, the crowd pops as this guy makes the walk to the octagon, and you can see why if you've watched film on him. This is a true mixed martial artist, plus skills in all areas, and figures to be a handful, really, for anybody in this division. Probably comfortable tonight anywhere the fight goes. Truly a well-rounded MMA fighter. You know, we trot that term out there a lot. This guy fits the bill.
This guy is a very well-rounded fighter. He can do it all. If the fight takes place standing or on the ground, he's gonna be comfortable in all areas of the game.
And now our tale of the tape.
All right, skip all those intros. I don't want to touch gloves. Oh, bitch.
Oh, there
we go.
Given what he did his last time out, it was a win by flush knockout. Now he'll try to keep the momentum going as the challenges get more difficult. You win in the UFC, 9 times out of 10, the next opponent is decidedly better. That is certainly the case here tonight.
Rip that hook to the body.
He's just standing there taking it. What the fuck? What's this guy doing? What's he doing? Bitch. Sometimes it's almost like the computer on like hard legendary, they always like, sometimes they wait, and then they boom, they want to parry it. But that's why I just keep throwing different shots, keep moving. I've played this game on the hardest difficulty, I fucking know how to beat it lower difficulty. But legendary is so stressful, I don't want to do it for the series. No, it's over. No, okay. Single collar. Block it, he's going to try and transition out of it. Oh no, he's not, okay. He might try and transition out of this. Ready? Bang! No. Get up, you fucking pansy. Bang, bang! Get up. Oh, this is easy. Get his fucking eye. His eye is smashed to bits. That was fucking flawless. Jesus, the step back overhand. Oh my god, that was fucking glorious. Oh. Look at that, blood all down that left arm. I don't know if it's going to show it. No, I don't think it will. That step back and then that overhand was fucking nasty. I didn't even need to ground and pound him. Just he bounced that one off. Bang. Oh, he took some damage to that right eye.
Well, what a moment for this fighter here tonight. A massive knockout on the sport's biggest stage. Seminal moment for that fighter tonight. We go right inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer. He has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest.
Smashed him hard. We smashed him. And once he started blocking, it was just over for him. And you know, see, I'm starting to get a feel for the game again. See, that step back and that overhand. Beautiful. Oh, shit. Jesus! I was gonna do another one, but... Oh my god, these could... Whoa. That's gonna have to be next episode, I think. That's too big to put in this one. Gonna have to be next episode. Gonna have to be. It's gonna have to be, yeah. Gonna be next episode, I'm afraid, guys. Where we will probably go up against... Probably Mark the Keys. Diakis? I don't know. Yeah. That could be a good fight, actually. Yeah, I'm not too bothered about Alexander Hernandez. He's a dickhead. We'll fight Mark. Diakis, if that's how you pronounce his name. One thing we haven't checked, of course, Khabib. Who's actually, yeah, and Mark Diakis is the lowest ranked out of those three fighters, because then you've got... And you've got, who was it? How is... What? Doesn't make sense, does it? Yeah, him, Alexander Hernandez. Conor McGregor's number 12. Tony Ferguson, of course, and then Khabib. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed, be sure to leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe down below. And I'll catch you in the next episode. It's going to be mad. We're going to have high rank, and then we're going to have our rival. It's going to be crazy. But yeah, catch you in the next one, guys. Peace.